the Messenger spacecraft will hit the surface of Mercury and crash at the end of April. Basically, we're out of fuel now. We're at the end of a really successful mission. And what happens, we can't do anything anymore to stop it from doing what it naturally wants to do. Because of the fact that Mercury does not have an atmosphere, the spacecraft will actually not burn out. So it will truly explode when it hits the surface. The University of Michigan built one of approximately 10 instruments that are part of the Messenger spacecraft. And so this instrument, the Fast Imaging Plasma Spectrometer, was invented here, was built here, and was tested here before it was mounted onto the spacecraft and got launched in 2004.
Main engine start, 2, 1, and 0, and liftoff of Messenger on NASA's mission to Mercury.
Technology that our engineers touched and worked with will be at the surface of Mercury for an eternity, for all we know.
FIPS made some really important contributions. First and foremost is that FIPS was the first instrument to measure ions in Mercury's space environment. So my responsibility for FIPS as an instrument scientist is to watch what it's doing on a daily basis. Not only do I look at the data every day, but every week I participate in the meetings where I get on the phone with a bunch of other Messenger folks and we make the plan for the next thing. Just yesterday we made the last plan. I don't want to overblow it, but honestly it makes me a little sad, you know, like something I'd really like coming to an end.
Great things have an end. I like that it doesn't fizzle out. We make discoveries till the last day at the height of the discoveries of this mission. Messenger basically made us aware of the fact that Mercury is in fact a planet that's geologically active.
With Messenger data, we actually showed that Mercury has, in its permanently shaded craters, so literally at its north pole, it has craters the bottom of which never see the sun, there's actually water ice in those craters.
You know, there are signs we discovered of recent massive volcanic activity that has shaped large fractions of the surface of the planet. Think of it like early in the solar system, the Earth stripped from all the outer surfaces. So it's going to take the inside of the Earth, going to throw away everything else and let it sit there and bake. This is our history. We've thought about this. We've stayed up at night because of it. We've written publications about it, and of course we will do so in the future, and we've made discoveries far beyond what we expected.
The catch is that if they don't perform as well as or better than the fuels we already have, you can have a net increase in the carbon emissions associated with these fuels. So we have to be careful and understand what their properties are.